Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. This is gonna be a pretty quick video, hopefully. I like to ramble. And, I just got a package from Australia. And this package is my honey cake purse. So right now, Australia's post is very slow. Like, I ordered this, like, the 8th of September or something. She sent it out on the 9th. Today is the 24th. And it just got to me. By the way, I wonder when this video is getting uploaded, because it's probably not going to be the 24th of September. I mean, maybe. I've got a lot of free time today, so maybe. I don't know. I've got another video that I just put up today, though. Well, last night at midnight, but still. So, first things first, she put little stickers at the very bottom. I covered up some stuff. But there's like a little sticker of a little animal butt and some hearts and stars. I just wanted to show that, and that's why I sharpied out the rest of it so I didn't have to worry about that and post it today. Maybe I'm learning. Maybe it's Maybelline. By the way, with it taking from the 8th till the 24th to get here, I also had express shipping and I got this package insured because it's a rare purse and it's ain't cheap. So, even with express shipping, it took like 20 days. I mean, like, I kind of knew that going into this, but, I am spoiled in the belief that express shipping should only take like a week maximum. And so I've had to be very patient for this package. But she said, like, hey, if you want your package this month, do express shipping. Because that's how it was. I open it up. There's a lot of packing paper, which is nice. So it's a cute little letter on some Kiki's delivery service paper. I'm covering up the name of the person. And it says, hello, thank you so much for your purchase. Please let me know when it arrived to you safely. Thanks, the person, and that little heart. Oh, no, it's just a normal piece of paper. She put a little Sheba sticker on it and some Kiki's Delivery Service washi tape. That's what it is. But you see there's a little, it's not a corgi, Sheba Inu. Then the little washi tape at the top and bottom. I thought it was like custom stationery for a second. It's a really sweet thing that she added a little note. Okay. The box was empty besides the paper and this. This is obviously the purse. It's in a bunch of bubble wrap. Bubble wrap burrito. Okay. In the bubble wrap, it's in pink paper. In the pink paper, it's in a plastic bag. And here it is. It is the honey cake bag by Angelic Pretty, new with tags, but it does have some minor staining on the bottom, like right there. I think there's some on the other side. Yeah, there's a little bit right there. You can barely see this stuff, but she took pictures of it. The back has a nice pocket. You can put like papers or receipts in there. The tags. It's nice seeing the original price of these things compared to what I paid for it. I only paid like twice what this was originally worth, which is pretty good. I actually got a nice deal because this one is slightly damaged. She also pointed out that in this ribbon, there's a little bit of the blue missing, like right there. But you can barely see it. You really have to nitpick to find it out. The lid of the box opens forward towards the front of the bag. And the straps are also wrapped up. Okay, the strap is no longer in its strap prison. The buckle on the strap is a little heart. Look at that. And the buttons that, the rivets that hold the straps on, I guess they're not actually buttons, it's attached. They're little hearts too. Inside the purse is a bunch of paper to make sure it didn't get crushed. Which is a nice touch. And then we get some silicone packets so it doesn't mold. There's two pockets on the inside. One's like big enough for like two, maybe three pens. It's a skinny but long one. And then the other is a little bit fatter, about two and a half times as fat as the pen one. It's kind of hard to see, but there you go. The box is a lot sturdier than I thought. I thought it would be like flexible. But no, this thing is hard. It's not gonna really lose its shape just by sitting, which is nice. I already mentioned that there's a pocket on the back for extra storage. Probably pretty thin things. I don't know what I would put in there. I don't want to put my phone in it because I think it would mess up with the pleather. Because I've got a pop socket on my phone, so my phone's not flat, so the pop socket would like point out with like my fingers, and I don't want that to damage it over time. But yeah, I got the honey cake purse. It's a nice size. This is a standard size sticky note. So it's like 2.5 sticky notes wide, maybe 3 tall. It's really cute. I'm happy I have it. I'm not sure if this is white or ivory, so I'm gonna get out actual honey cake and compare. Okay, I've got honey cake here. Yes, I keep this one in a garment bag because when you have a dress that is this expensive, you put it in a garment bag. Most of my other dresses are like a quarter of the price of this one. So here's a bit of the skirt. The colors, of course, match really well because it's the same illustration, basically. Except for this one's on polyester, so there's like a slight difference, but it's still the same color. But as expected, this is pure white and this is ivory. I'm gonna get over it because it's the same release and the purse doesn't come in other colors, but if you care about the fact that this is white and this is ivory, that who else is buying honey cake here? I don't know. Tons of people probably. Okay, so that's the video. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and what was your first Lolita purse? Technically this one's mine. I ordered some other ones before this one, but they're not gonna show up until like next month, so we'll figure that out. Those are custom made ones from Cotton Candy Feet, so this one is technically my first one. First brand dress, first brand bag, and first bag in general. Nice. That's pretty good. You can't tell. I am a secret brand whore at heart. But maybe just for honey cake. Bye. I'll see you in my next video.